See, Nick, I don't like to steal your thunder. That makes me upset. So I'm going to tee up some thunder for you because you mentioned something very interesting in our pre-production meeting. The Yankees do lead the major leagues in errors, and a big part of that has been from catcher Gary Sanchez. And as you mentioned earlier, before we got on, Aaron Boone might have a huge decision to make come postseason time, whether it be going with Gary Sanchez and going with the possibility that his bat comes alive, or going ahead with the backup in Kyle Higashioka, who Garrett Cole likes to pitch with, who other pitchers feel more comfortable with than Sanchez. It feels like there's a big quandary on the head of Aaron Boone coming into this postseason with the catcher position.
Well, the errors have been difficult, and you can say that Sanchez hasn't helped the cause because I don't think anyone's sitting there saying he's an excellent defender. That's never been Gary Sanchez's MO. But Gleyber Torres has not transitioned fantastically at shortstop, playing defensively. The outfield at times has not played great. One of the guys that sticks out to me who's playing less and less now is Brett Gardner, who is a guy who won a gold glove back in 2016. And I have not felt has played great defense this year, which is tough for him because that's really his role, to play good defense. And especially if he's going to hit the way he's hit, I haven't been overly impressed with the way he's done that. Luke Voit has been another one who has never been a guy who you're sitting there hanging your hat on how good he's going to be defensively. They do have Urshela and LeMahieu, who have also played spotty defense at times. They're like, that's everyone makes errors. It happens, but that has also been the case when you lead the league in errors. So it hasn't been pretty defensively. To answer the idea about Sanchez, I'm really confused about where the Yankees are going with this, because I get it, as I just alluded to, that Sanchez is not a great defender, but Higashioka isn't good defensively either. And can we stop pretending like he is because he's just not Gary Sanchez? Because I watched the game. I'm old enough to remember. I watched the game last night when Kyle Higashioka had a guy dead to rights in a rundown and placed between the two numbers on his back. And that's a sure out that the Yankees need to get, and ultimately leads to them losing that game when LeMahieu can't come through in the bottom half. So I just don't know where this love for Higashioka comes from, because he hasn't done anything offensively either. So to me, let's roll with the dude who has the upside in Gary Sanchez, guy who's the second fastest to 100 home runs in major league history. I get it. It hasn't been there this year. I'm not here to defend what Gary Sanchez has done. He did have two hits last night. He hit a ball to the warning track. You might have thought a little bit differently about Gary Sanchez's season if he came through and pinch hit with a grand slam instead of Grichuk making a great play on the warning track in left center in that game the other night. But I'm just rolling with Gary because I think the offensive upside is there. And by the way, maybe if the rest of this lineup was hitting, you may have a different conversation. You may say, okay, well, we've got Judge rolling, Stanton rolling, Torres rolling. So you know what? We can afford to take a step back and say, we don't need to bet on Gary Sanchez's upside because we're good enough offensively and Higashioka is going to play better defense. I don't think that's the case. They're not well enough.
Yeah, and you mentioned it. Higashioka isn't eons above Sanchez defensively. And the hope is that his bat comes alive, because we know what Sanchez can do when he gets hot and you leave him there towards the bottom of the lineup. I mean, this Yankees team, that offense is essentially a juggernaut when you can have that balance there, especially with Sanchez down there. Sometimes Gleyber is down, depending on how the lineup goes. But when you look at the Yankees now, and God bless the hearts of the Minnesota Twins, it just feels like wherever the Twins are, the Yankees are. The Yankees currently stand in sixth. So they would see the Twins in that 3-6 matchup, but they still could drop to eighth, depending on what happens to finish out this weekend with the Marlins. They could easily fall to that eighth spot and potentially see the Rays. Nick, what do you think about the Yankees' chances? I mean, does it matter who they play in that first round? If they happen to get that eighth seed and face the Tampa Bay Rays, are you concerned at all? Because I don't think, depending on where the Yankees are, they have a shot to beat anybody in the first round. So I think for the Yankees, as long as they can get in, they know they've clinched a berth. I mean, I'm sure they'd love to face the Minnesota Twins and beat up on them as they traditionally do in the postseason. But it feels like for the Yankees, with everybody there and everybody mostly healthy, I don't think they'll have any fear in facing the Tampa Bay Rays in the first round and get that out of the way. Because if they can take out the Rays, that opens up the entire field for them to get to the World Series.
Look, they're the New York Yankees, and they're as talented as any team in the majors. So maybe they shouldn't be afraid, but I wouldn't want to play the Tampa Bay Rays. You go 2-8 against a team throughout the regular season, that's not a team I want to see with three games fighting for my life or I'm going home. So I have no interest in playing the Tampa Bay Rays. Further, I have no interest in playing the Tampa Bay Rays at Tropicana Field, a place the Yankees have never played well. This group has never played well at Tropicana Field. So I don't want to see the Rays, because we talk about pitching, right? We just lined this thing up in our last segment about the Dodgers, and you don't want to see this. Yes, the Yankees have some pitching in a three-game series. The Rays don't want to see Garrett Cole in game one either. That's another thing that I've mentioned and talked about. Is the conventional wisdom 100% right that Garrett Cole would pitch game one? I don't know that that's 100% the way they want to go. We'll see. But the Yankees would line up Cole. I think Tanaka is the number two. And right now it might be Jay Happ who's in your three spot. I don't know, but they'll figure out that pitching lineup. Davey Garcia may have a say in there too, although he hasn't been as solid in his last couple outings. Hasn't been bad, but a guy, that's a lot to put on a youngster's plate there. You want to face Blake Snell and Charlie Morton? That's just with the bullpen that they have. The Rays and Tyler Glasnow, right? They have. I think the Rays may have the best starting pitching staff in the American League, and I don't. I don't know if it's even that controversial. So I don't think you want to see that in a three game series. The Yankees are going to have to go through the Rays at some point if they want to get to where they want to go. But I think that everyone would agree that it's going to be a much more favorable matchup if it's in a 5-game series at a neutral site or in a 7-game series in a neutral site, as opposed to having to rely on the 3 games where the Rays can just roll them out on the road, having to travel. That doesn't sound like it's a great idea for the Yankees, where a 7-game series may actually play to the Yankees' advantage, because the way that the bubble is going to work out, it's going to be 7 games in 7 days if it goes all 7 games. So the advantage for the Rays in the starting pitching may be minimized, because you can't throw a starter multiple times throughout a series, or if you do, it's going to be at the back end. You're certainly not going to see anyone 3 times, although that is detrimental to the Yankees because they can't roll out Cole 3 times. But we'll see. I don't want to see the Rays. The Twins, fine. I don't know that the Yankees want to play on the road. That's not something they want to do. That's where they're going to be. They're going to be on the road for those 3 games. So it's about the Yankees. It's about the Yankees showing up and being the team that they said they were going to be and have been at times. But 5 games without hitting home runs is concerning. And some of the guys who have struggled this year, that's concerning. And 5 double plays is not something that is what this team was expected to do in a game last night. So they got to check their own boxes. And I know that they're capable, but these are big games they're playing at the end, and they're not showing up either. So maybe the playoffs are a different intensity. Maybe they can flip on a switch, but they haven't shown it against the Marlins. And then if that gives you confidence against the Rays, I don't know why it would. This team is just difficult to figure out. And I don't know how you could be supremely confident right now.
No, yeah, and my thinking is if you are going to flip the switch and keep it on and light a fire under this team that's played so sporadically throughout a 60-game season, maybe it might just be against the number one seed Rays. Maybe that's that motivation or that extra incentive this team needs to know that, hey, if we can't beat the Rays in a 3-game series, we're going home. But if we can catch the Rays, then we become the prohibitive favorites. And now everyone is looking at us in the American League as that team that'll get to the World Series and potentially face someone like the Los Angeles Dodgers. But again, we will see.